Welcome back to another episode of Coffee Talk, and I'm here with Morgan Chegg-Whitten, and she is here to talk a little bit about the successes of the Pets Alive program. So, Morgan, yeah, just tell us a little bit what you got going on with that.
Yeah, so we adopted San Angelo Pets Alive in April 2019. It was a really great program to consider for our community because it's very data-driven. We have a lot of the support from American Pets Alive, located in Austin, Texas. They offer a tremendous amount of support for training and best practices and policies and programs, and they've made us their little project. And so we're really grateful for that support because we, of course, had adopted a plan to get to a 90% live release rate for our animal shelter for the number of animals that are actually leaving alive versus euthanized. And so we were able to go from 47% of animals released alive in fiscal year 18 and hit our goal for fiscal year 19 of 60% of animals released alive.
Wow. So how did you do that?
So it's a bunch of things working together. Pets Alive says, here are the 12 tenets of our program. These are the things you need to consider, but it's a lot, right? Like, where do you start? So they said, pick two things and get really good at them. And so one of the things we really focused on this year was return to owner, the number of animals getting owner redeemed. And that includes your traditional, like, hey, I lost my dog. You come by the shelter, you find your dog, happy ending, right? That also includes returning to field any wildlife because who is their owner but, you know, Mother Nature. Sure. And so we're just better tracking that information and really showing. And so we did a tremendous number of large-scale microchip clinics. For example, in June 2019, we microchipped more animals than the whole fiscal year prior. And so we had over 800 owner redemptions in fiscal year 19, and that's more than double what we had done in any prior years. And so American Pets Alive says you've really got to have progressive return to owner policies. These pets have a home. Somebody's invested in this animal. They love this animal. They want it back. You know, you need to find a way to partner with these families and get those pets back where they belong.
Okay, so how does the community continue to help you guys get to your 90% goal?
Yes, so going from 47% to 60% in 1 year seemed really difficult, and going from 60% to 72% in this coming year, also, I don't know how we're going to do it, but we keep working these programs, we keep leaning on our resources, but most importantly, we reach out to the community. In November, we had a really tough month. We shared, hey guys, we're full, we need some help, we need some support, and this community came out in force and really came alongside us as a partner and took animals out of our shelter and fostering, adopting, claiming their pets that they owned, and that is huge. So that is really what we're looking for, is for folks that are considering supporting, considering helping. We're just so grateful for those that got us to our 60% live release rate, because you did so much at each and every animal that left. If you adopted a kitten, if you owner redeemed your dog, whatever it is, those individual things add up, and that's what's making us successful. And so moving into the new year, you know, one program we're really proud about is our Good Samaritan program. And it's where, let's say you're out and about on your daily tasks and you run across a dog and you're like, oh dear, what's going on with this dog? So you bring it by the shelter, you scan it for a microchip. It's not microchipped. And we say, hey, you've already invested a lot of your day in trying to track down this dog, get it to a secure place. We want to set him up for success coming into the shelter and prevent him from catching any diseases. So totally optional program where we vaccinate the animal, we post him on helpmegethome.com, which is a local lost and found site, and we send them home with you for 72 hours. Again, totally optional. Some people aren't in that position. We completely understand. But by the time you've invested in that animal and done so much, maybe you want to take that extra time. And so we can go ahead and vaccinate that animal, send it home with you for 72 hours. When you bring it back, we give you like a fast pass, no paperwork. You've already done all that. And you bring that animal back and it's set up for success. Doesn't get kennel cough, doesn't get any life-threatening diseases because you were able to make that investment.
Well, thank you so much, Morgan. I really appreciate you coming on and just, you know, talking about your success. And congratulations, and I hope it only goes up.